What's up, y'all? This is your boy, Movie Man Greg, coming at you guys with another reaction. And today, we're going to be starting the one and only Sopranos. First episode, season one. Now, this won the actual vote. It was between this and some other shows, such as The Wire, Game of Thrones. But I've seen Game of Thrones, but I was willing to do a rewatch, you know, to try to catch things that I've never caught before. But this one actually won, so we're going to go ahead and get this started. I've never seen any episodes, but my brother and my mom told me that this show is phenomenal, that this is like one of their top shows. So I'm excited to really get into it. Now, if you are watching this on Patreon, again, thank you. I appreciate y'all. I love y'all for being members. I truly do. With these videos, as far as for the TV shows, I watched all the seasons first, and then I start to release them out on YouTube. So if you want to see these type of shows early, all you got to do is become a Patreon member, where you'll be able to see these completely uncut and unedited. But with that being said, I'm excited. Let's go ahead and start this reaction. Oh, and if you're not a member, make sure you go to patreon.com/2epic to become a member for benefits when it comes to the movie reactions and music reactions. If you want to be a part of any giveaways, then you go to my OnlyFans under 2epic Productions. All right? That's all I got. Let's go ahead and start this show. I am... That reminds me of Nas. Woke up this morning, you got yourself a gun. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh wow, Nas really sampled this. Like, he sampled this song. You got yourself a gun. Damn! Damn, time out! Hey. This intro just got that much better knowing, like, oh shit. Like, not, that's one of my favorite songs. Nas, Got Yourself a Gun. But I didn't know it was sampled off of this. Like, so that's, yeah, I'm excited. Let's go ahead and get it going. The Sopranos. I love this intro now just because of that little simple fact. All right, here we go. That was dope. This is supposed to be therapy. Is this court-appointed therapy or something? I'm intrigued to know.
Negative. Nay sent me here.
You don't agree that you had a panic attack?
I don't want to be here. Obviously.
I don't know. Stress, maybe.
What are you stressed about?
About what?
You're like, I don't want to get into this shit with you.
How do you stay so skinny, Mrs. Soprano? Him with those ducks.
The stress.
Hey, kids, come here. Come here, I'm trying to fly.
He really into the ducks.
National Geographic. Yeah,
maybe in his line of work, he's like, it's the simple things.
Your party, right? Birdman, hello?
Yeah, I got home early from work.
Damn, he really into these birds, reading an encyclopedia.
Did you get up early this morning, Cole? He's always in his office by 6.
I was nauseous this morning. My mother told me I shouldn't even come in.
Excuses. Damn, that Lexus was 60,000? Holy shit.
If a patient comes to me and tells me a story where someone's going to get hurt, I'm supposed to go to the authorities.
Yeah.
Technically. I'm just saying.
Nothing. We had coffee.
Okay. Like, yeah, I'm not telling you everything we just did. at his job. Oh! Ooh! He like, why send a boy to do a man's job? Oh, shit. My man's booking it. Look, he enjoying this shit. Yo, 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 yo! Oh! 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 Legs gone! Oh, yeah, oh.
You all right?
My body's broken apart.
Oh. Oh, where my money, man? With my money, man. Ooh.
Fucking mouth, because you tell people I'm nothing compared to the people that used to run.
I'm sorry.
Sorry. Sorry.
Shut up.
I hope it's more than $3,000, because you're going to have to give him that money from HMO, him.
Huh? You're covered. You're
like, dude. You got health coverage from the company you're working with.
Stop. That's the thing. They won't. He says if he could tell the commie bosses back in Czechoslovakia to go fuck themselves, he could fucking tell us.
Ooh, okay.
Is your Uncle Junior gonna whack Pussy Malanga?
Okay.
Do it at your friend Artie Bucco's restaurant.
Ah, damn. He about to kill somebody at his boy's restaurant. Alrighty. Did I catch that right? I'm not sure if I'm picking up on the terminology just yet, but he said he's gonna whack him at the restaurant.
Hey. Oh, howdy. How's your rash?
And she's like, oh, look what the captain drug in.
Veronta, one of these old mutts gets wet in here.
Yeah, run his business.
You better sit down with your uncle.
Yeah.
When I was young, he told my girl cousins I would never be a varsity athlete, and frankly, that was a tremendous blow to my self-esteem.
Like, I'm not doing that because of you, Uncle Junior. You could have encouraged me a little bit, just a little bit.
Music, all the old stuff's being reissued on CD, all your old favorites. Pajama Game, Connie Francis. Here.
Man. Y'all remember those? Stereo players? Boom boxes? Man. This shit was ages ago. Did they even make these anymore?
If your uncle has business with Arthur, he knows what he's doing.
Like, I need you to talk to him, Ma.
I don't.
Oh. Oh.
Well, all I know is daughters are better at taking care of their mothers than sons.
Damn. I brought CDs for a broken record.
You're a healthy girl. It's good for you to drive. Use it or lose it. I gotta go to work.
Use it or lose it. Call her Uber, bro. Yep. Uber was the greatest thing invented 20, 30 years later.
I just called. Started crying and hung up.
She needs a purpose in life.
No, your mother is tougher than you think.
So what? No fucking Z?
Damn. Wow. I'm not getting no baked ziti on my birthday? He love them ducks. It's a simple thing. The little simple pleasures. Just watching something that's so innocent. Just live. He probably deal with so much chaos all the time where he tries to appreciate these type of things. And then they just flew off.
Ginger ale in my skull.
Oh. Oh. Oh, that shit about to blow up.
Mom, Daddy just fell. Mom,
where? Yeah. Tony.
Oh, my God.
Oh, is that shit? Oh, okay. Was it the shock of that one little simple thing he's been trying to enjoy taking flight and dipping off?
spiritual mentor. He's helping me to be a better Catholic.
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, we all got different needs.
What's different between you and me is you're going to hell when you die.
Woo! Shit! Shit! Okay. We get a little bit of insight on their relationship. She knows what his life is about. She don't condone it, but hell, what can she do about it?
Sausages? No, I thought the only sausages they had was Italian and Jimmy Dean's. See what you learn when you cross cultures and shit?
Oh, Monty used to play my cousin Gregory in football. He went to Boone.
Where's his stuff?
Like, enough of the small talk, man. Like, I'm trying to get to the shit. A-mail. Oh, just the guy that got a whack in the restaurant. Wasn't it? Ooh. Damn. How many times you gotta shoot him, bro? I think he good.
Who do you think you are?
I'm the person who says how things go. That's who I think.
Okay. So he trying to be the new boss.
How many hours did I spend playing catch with you?
Can we focus?
Hold on, I need to rewind it. I need to make sure I catch what just happened.
You kill him someplace else.
You may run North Jersey, but you don't run your Uncle Junior. How many fucking hours did I spend playing catch with you?
Okay. So two things at play. He's making his power move. But also, he's like, yo, we can't kill him there. That's going to hurt his business. Okay, I'm following along.
What do you have, raccoons?
Somebody's jimmying a window.
What?
You have all these security lights. Who would try and,
Ooh, get the guns. Woo! Ooh.
Don't give me that. You snuck out!
What's going on?
You locked my bedroom window on purpose so I get caught.
Normal people.
Yo, she was about to get lit up.
The Scangarello, that's where you're not going.
Yep.
But this shit I'm telling you, it'll all blow over.
Hey, time out. The wife was ready, though. She went to the stash, she got the AK. She was ready to fuck up somebody's day. Like, damn, Karn. Like, she was about that life. She said somebody's jimmying a window. She knew what the fuck that sounded like, too. Like, man. Alrighty. Alright, Karn.
Melfi.
Trying to deflect.
Evelino. My mother would have loved it if you and I got together.
Deflecting and trying to change the subject.
Whatever happened to Gary Cooper? The strong, silent type. That was an American. He wasn't in touch with his feelings.
And that is function of my fungal.
You have strong feelings about this.
Let me tell you something. I had a semester and a half of college.
A semester and a half.
Do you feel depressed?
That's the question.
Do you feel depressed?
Are you a liar? Sometimes.
Since the ducks left.
Ooh, I think I called it.
The ducks that preceded you losing consciousness. Let's talk about them.
Yeah, that was his little piece. That was his happy moments. And they dipped out on his ass.
I just fucking wet a guy to hold on to one of our stops.
He's not running it down. It's just getting hotter in New York.
Damn, they got tossed his ass up there? They're not gonna make it. Oh.
Maybe he'll turn up. If. Come on. Let's get him. Got him?
They trying to throw him up there? Okay.
What goes on behind here?
Those doors lead to our nursing unit.
This is a nursing home.
Uh-huh. She's like, you is not about to put me in this shit.
Your fancy office.
Ma.
I know every people Ma. Come here to die.
Oh, another pass out.
Oh my God. Somebody get a doctor.
It's the stress. Stress is killing my man. And you landed yourself right back in here.
There's that D word again.
Depression. Yeah, you gotta talk about it, bro.
Now that my father's dead, he's a saint. When he was alive, nothing.
Not a damn thing. A scrub, buster, loser, punk.
He ran his own crew.
Oh.
Guy like that, and my mother wore him down to a little nub.
Oh, damn.
He was just squeaking.
Do you have any qualms about how you actually make a living?
Yeah.
That shit's stressful.
Pharmacology, no one needs to suffer
with feelings of exhaustion and depression.
Here we go. Here comes the Prozac.
And the man over with the car, T himself.
The man has no wiggle room. He's bled dry.
I need my money, man. He better find the money.
And before him, and now, you. So sure, he can't stomach you telling him what to do.
Well, he better... They ain't about to say you gotta whack his uncle.
Restaurant. Get him out of town for 3 weeks. That way the restaurant closes. The hit has to go down someplace else.
Ooh, genius. Genius. Oh, damn.
Set up. Or he pays Hesh the 250 grand he owes him, which we know he cannot do.
Damn, he owed 250 grand.
Or it's a rainy night in Lyndhurst.
That dude owed 250 grand. No wonder he got his legs ran over. So how the HMOs, they'll make claims, fake claims, and the HMOs will pay those claims if you funnel it into them. Yeesh! Insurance fraud.
Maddow, it's our little tradition. We always have so much fun.
Tell you the truth, I felt it was dumb since I was 8.
Damn. Damn. Since you was 8.
You listen to me?
Yeah.
A couple of dentists got together, and in appreciation, they awarded me these tickets. Problem is, I can't get away those days.
You run a restaurant. You can't get away that either. You gotta think of a better lie.
Anthony. Thank you. All right.
He ain't gonna do it.
In any possible scenario under which dentist ascending the dawn of New Jersey, first class on a Norwegian steamship. Come on.
Ah, shit. Somebody donated the kneecaps. Right there.
That's a shame. A medication comes along after your gambling gets your fucking hip busted to shit.
I'm trying not to be cynical.
They about to toss his ass over. You better come to your senses real quick, bro. You better say, yeah, I do it. Yeah, I figure it out. Yeah, I do it.
That's right.
Yeah.
What you were saying before, you know, the MRIs.
Yep. Man, that was the most subtle yet effective threat ever. Prozac.
I can't. What are you talking about? We discussed this. You gotta leave town. I'm sorry.
Damn. Aw, shit.
How you doing?
Giuseppe.
Good to see you.
How you doing?
Hey,
senor.
Hello.
Come sta? This way. Excuse me.
And he just walked right in.
Impossible.
Hey, listen. Those decorator tips you gave me. they really work.
She's like, I don't want to see you out in public.
Decorating tips. Yeah, right.
Neil, shut the fuck up.
Yeah. Woo! Just like that. Yup. She got the juice. Wait a minute. That wasn't his wife, obviously.
Soprano. Buonasera. Months we don't see you. Where you been? Signora Carmen.
Wait. Did he go? He went to the restaurant. I just realized he wasn't with his damn wife.
Why don't we just go to another
restaurant? Oh, shit. That is not his wife.
Soprano, how you doing?
Giuseppe.
Good to see you.
How you doing?
Holy shit. Damn, I didn't put two to two together. Damn.
Setting up your table.
And he goes there with his wife. And they know.
Buonasera. Months we don't see you. Where you been? Signora Carmen.
Laid it on thick. Where have you been? We haven't seen you in so long. This show is amazing, y'all.
You've been in good spirits the last couple days.
Yeah. You got a new piece of tail.
Something I gotta confess.
I got a new piece of tail.
Oh my god.
I've been seeing a therapist.
Oh my god. I think that's great. I think that's so wonderful.
Wow. Calm down.
Well, you think I was Hannibal Lecter before or something?
I just think it's great. Psychology doesn't address the soul, that's something else, but this is a start.
Psychology doesn't address the soul.
The wrong person finds out about this and I get a steel jacket and antidepressant right in the back of the head.
Antidepressant, back of the head.
Hey, a friend of ours just got back in town.
Little Pussy Malanga, sometimes confused with fellow reputed mobster Big Pussy Bombancero.
Dang, that's, they really go by those names. They really go by those names.
Dad, don't you think it's totally out there? I mean, my Aspen trip. What is she thinking?
You were sneaking out.
You know, your mother thinks you have the capacity to be a top student. And I agree.
What do you guys want? Perfection?
Yeah. Yeah.
But they knew how to build it. Go out now and find me two guys that can put decent grater on your bathtub.
It's like, yeah, man. They did this shit with their hands and their wits. Oh, is this shit about to blow up? Did he put a bomb in there? Yeah. He had that walk.
I'm working on screwing it. And when I get it unscrewed, my penis falls off.
Oh, damn. That's not a dream. That's a nightmare, bro. What does that mean?
Bird swoops down, grabs it in its beak.
Oh, man. That's a fucking nightmare.
It's goddamn ducks.
What is it about those ducks that meant so much to you?
You put in time.
I was sad to see him go. Oh, Jesus, fuck, now he's gonna cry.
Oh, shit. Oh, shit. I don't wanna fucking talk about this shit no more. This is the shit I don't wanna do.
It's a link. Family. Connection. I'm afraid I'm gonna lose my family. I think I lost the ducks.
Yeah, see? I knew it was something deeper than that.
I don't know.
My wife is gonna take my kids and dip the fuck out. Or worse, somebody get hurt.
Stove. Suppose people stop coming to the restaurant. You ever think of that?
I don't know what the fuck.
What?
Hoping helps.
That's right.
That's right, he's right.
Talking helps.
You know, a simple way to go, Chris, on the Triborough Towers contract would have been nice.
Oh, he wants recognition. He wants an attaboy.
What are you gonna do, go ahead and refill on me now? How many mobsters are selling screenplays and screwing everything up?
She said I could maybe even play myself.
Wow. Wow.
We got work to do. New avenues. Everything's gonna be all right from here on in. Come on.
He's like, man, I don't want to be part of this shit. I'm trying to. I could have been an actor, bro. And it's funny that he's an actor, you know?
Drive me anywhere. Well, if his father was still alive, you can bet your boots he'd show more decency and respect for his
mother. I feel it, though. I ain't trying to go to no nursing home when I get older.
He was a saint.
Anyway. He's bullshit.
But I'm all agita all the time.
And I'll tell you something else. Things are down all across the board. A lot of friends of ours are complaining.
Ooh. Not anymore. Nope.
You take a larger hand in things. Something may have to be done, Livia. About to.
Oh. Oh. Oh.
Hey, there you are. Hey, Ma. Uncle June.
You're using mesquite. That makes the sausage taste peculiar.
Hi, Grandma.
Wow.
Happy birthday, my big boy.
Carmela, my mother's here.
She's made it here to bring light and joy to the entire family, the entire household. Is the ducks gonna come back?
The beast in me.
Okay, that was the first episode. All right. And there we have it, people. First episode of The Sopranos season one. I am excited. This is good. Like, I'm thoroughly enjoying the storyteller. You know, like he's in therapy. So that's number one. That's pretty cool that they have it where he's in therapy. He's going through all this stuff, but he's telling his stories to his therapist day by day on what he's going through. I'm not sure if that's the premise of the whole show where he's going to continue to do this, but I'm not mad at it if it is. Is there going to be a point where he's no longer in therapy and then just continues to go and he's just telling his story? Or I'm not sure, but if it continues this way, it's pretty interesting. It's also pretty good. I like how they're showing the emotional side of him, on him being vulnerable, not by choice though. Like, he's trying to fight it. Yo, this therapy shit. It's not for men. It's like, why can't we go back to how it was in the 1930s where you took your problems, you swallowed them deep, and you never spoke anything above it. You just did what you had to do, you know. But to see that therapy is actually helping him a little bit, especially in the first episode, is pretty cool. I wouldn't have thought that they would put something like that in The Sopranos. The relationships between everybody, him becoming the boss, like he's getting his footing on being the top boss. And there's already people, powers that be, that's like, nah, I'm not comfortable with this. His family, like his Uncle Junior. So, and then his wife. His wife knows about that life, and she pretty much says he's going to be going to hell. So I'm really digging all the characters so far, and I'm excited to continue on with this. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this. Again, if you're members, again, I appreciate you. I love y'all. Thank you so much. I'm going to keep diving deep into this. I'm probably going to binge the shit out of this, as quickly as possible. But if you're not members already, again, consider becoming a member. My members, they pretty much had access to these videos unedited, you know, a lot sooner than when you guys are watching it on the YouTube edits. But again, thanks again. I appreciate y'all. Love y'all. And I will catch you guys on the next reaction. Until then, peace. Alrighty. Where's my stop button?